Testing.
Hey folks, welcome back. I am going to be making a two-prong meat fork tonight. This is a mild steel block. This is probably plenty of material. I'm guessing that I'm gonna have excess here, but that's okay. Always good to have more than not enough. So there's a few different ways to go about this. The most two obvious methods that come to my mind, now take it that I've never done this before, so I'm making this up as I go, but the two methods that come to my mind would be splitting it, taking the two pieces out to make your prongs, or upsetting the bar and forming a T shape, and then taking the prongs from the T. And if you go check out one of our earlier videos that's called Spontaneous Axe Challenge, I made an axe using that same basic technique. This time we're gonna use the technique to make a meat fork. So I'm gonna go with the upsetting technique, pop this in the fork. We're gonna redo that, Jacob. We'll pop this in the forge. There we go. And first step will be up, doing a little bit of upsetting, and then I can shoulder down and start forming a T shape out of the material.
I can grab it, but I can't hold it under the power.
On this next heat, I'm going to begin taking that top head part and then drawing out that the pieces of the T lengthwise. So we'll get some legs coming off of it, and those will be the actual forks. And I'm going to be upsetting that in the hardy hole of my smaller anvil.
Yeah, buddy. and start drawing out the other part.
I've got the prongs, or the forks, the tines, whatever you want to call them, of the meat fork forged out, and now I want to hot rasp them to give them like a nicer finish without having to do much grinding. So now that we have the tines hot rasped and a fairly decent finish on them, just straight from the forge, I think it's time to bend them just into a rough shape. That way I can manage the handle part easier, because right now it's really awkward being so long and perpendicular to the handle.
Like a trident,
yeah. But
only two. A duo dent. Looks like Satan's horns. That's pretty cool. How about that? Cool, huh?
Yeah, that's so cool. We are going to get Mercer's reaction to the new belt grinder. He's not seen it yet. Okay, unfold. I think he's scared of it. Are you intimidated by it?
A little bit.
I would be. The thing's gonna eat your face off. Just imagine, like, you're grinding and then I come out and take your legs out from under you and you just fall in and you get ground off.
There we go, we got a gen 10 on our game.
Yeah. Or, yeah, your fingers get sucked through this and it just pulls your arm out of socket. Got the taper for the length of the handle, and I've taken the last little bit and drawn it out smaller and made it round. That's going to be a loop that I'm going to make. So I'm first going to make a little bit of a scroll and then bend the whole thing over maybe like 75 degrees and then make a loop so that it can be hung on a hook or something. First up, just a little scroll. Just a little cutesy wootsy. You know, like that. Trying to get this base aligned, and then I can adjust the forks so they're not crossed. And I want to also put a downward bend
the off-road curve to it also. Did you see that? So, just a reminder, I've never done this before, so I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm just making something that I think looks like a cool meat fork, and hopefully it really works. Is that how a meat fork is supposed to be? Yeah? Now that the fork has been forced, I need to put the final finish on it. And that is going to be done with some boiled linseed oil. So I'll heat this up and apply it hot. This is a little bit too hot. It's red colored. That's a little bit too hot. I want to get a black heat and apply this stuff, and it's going to be really smoky and nasty, but it'll put a really dark black finish onto the steel, as opposed to this gray finish. See, back here is about the right temperature, so I'm going to wait for this to cool down, and then I'll start applying. Yeah, it's starting to turn black there. Just keep rubbing it on there so it works in like that. Oil finish. So I need to put my logo in this steel. It's mild steel, so I think I might be able to hammer it in cold. Your boy. Right there. That's it right there. Well, that was a really fun project, and I think that it went fairly well. I don't intend for this video to be a how-to video, because this is me learning also for the first time how to make a meat fork. And I'm sure there are many other ways to make meat forks, but it was a fun challenge. And I got to forge in a way that I haven't forged in a long time, because I've been making so many axes lately. I hope that you enjoyed it as well. And if you aren't subscribed to us already, be sure to do that to see more stuff like this in the future. And if you are already subscribed, turn on that notification bell so that you can see
whenever we post the video. All right, I'll see you in the next one.
Yeah.